אתם עם SBS בעברית.
Hi, my name is Oren Thaler and I'm a high school teacher and also I have a master's degree in peace and conflict studies from the University of Sydney.
Oren, thank you for joining us today. Welcome to Shalom Australia on SBS Radio. I'd like to talk to you about the coming election in Israel. It's going to be the fourth election in 2 years. What is new under the sun with this election?
All the elections seem to be going over the same old issues. This one is very, very different because we had a lot of changes in the past year that has affected the issues and also affected the players. There's new political players that have come into the election.
Well, it's been a difficult year for Israel and for all over the world with the pandemic, but we can see that Netanyahu had two major achievements, his peace with four Arab countries and getting Pfizer vaccination for all the population of Israel. This is amazing. So why do you think that with such big achievements, there is now opposition to him that may even topple him?
Yeah, true. Just the peace agreements could have or should have in another time or another situation should have lasted him for another 10 years in office, because this is a very big change and achievement. And also the vaccination is an achievement, and that will really help Israel's recovery. However, the pandemic also exposed big weakness of Netanyahu, which is the dependency on the Haredi, the ultra-Orthodox community, and his, in a way, inability to enforce the laws that were demanded during the pandemic, which the Haredi community in big numbers wasn't willing to comply with.
Right. So who is standing against Netanyahu this time?
The major change this time is the rise of Gideon Saar and his party, the New Hope. The difference here is that Gideon Saar comes from the Likud party itself and has managed to gather some of Netanyahu's traditional support. And that might be enough to be a game changer, because even if it's going to be only 5 seats taken from the Likud party, or 5 or 6 seats, that might be enough to be able to form a government that is without the Likud party, which wasn't the case in the previous round.
So let's say if Gideon Saar gets 5 or 6 seats, who will be his partners?
Theoretically, there should be just a right-wing, a full right-wing party, if the division was along ideological lines of right and left. But in this situation, the division is Netanyahu or anti-Netanyahu. Seems like there are enough players now that are willing to form a coalition without Netanyahu, and perhaps if that's the numbers will play right for them, there could be a possibility that they will create a coalition between, let's say, Lapid, which is Yesh Atid on one hand, Gideon Saar, which is New Hope, and Bennett Yemina, the right-wing party. They might form a coalition that leaves the Likud out of it and Netanyahu out of the coalition. But that is still an unsure situation, but it is more possible than has been in the past.
And what happened to the Israeli left? What happened to the Labour Party and to Meretz? Because all the polls actually predicting that Meretz won't even get one seat.
Meretz, I think their biggest weakness, biggest mistake is that they're still adhering to things that have kind of shown to be impractical at all. For example, the Oslo peace agreement or the two-state solution that Meretz is advocating for very zealously. We've kind of learned to see that is not so popular and probably not very pragmatic. And that's why people are kind of starting to leave Meretz and join to more mainstream or centralist parties. Whereas in the past, more people had hope that that was the way to go. So I think that's part of Meretz's demise, and also the Labour Party, which even in these days is still trying to represent that kind of ideology. Whereas Lapid has in many ways quieted or discarded that kind of policy and tries to focus on more pragmatic policies where it comes to the Middle East crisis or the Middle East conflict.
But it seems that people that are on the center-left may still vote for Lapid, and they won't like the matchmaking between Lapid and Bennett, which is more right-wing than Netanyahu, and Gideon Saar, also very right-wing. How can you marry them together?
Yeah, I think in this case, that won't be much of a problem because people in general, and especially Lapid's voters, won't have a problem with that because the conflict issues are not on the agenda at all. And right now, the main issue is yes, Bibi, no, Bibi. All people care about now when they vote is, or the people that vote, I mean, for Lapid, let's say, for example, or even to Gideon Saar, are how to get Netanyahu out of office. Again, even though or despite his great successes in many of the things in the last years.
Yeah, it is a very interesting election because from my conversation with people, they are too scared now to vote for fringe parties, that they will disappear in the next election and they are wasting their vote if they won't even get one seat. And other people telling me that there is no leadership but Bibi. No, there is no other leader that they can trust.
It's pretty amazing the way Netanyahu in the last 10 years or even more, 11, 12 years, has managed to secure his role as the ultimate leader, if you want, that doesn't have any replacement. He's done it, first of all, because of his own merits, and that can't be disputed, but also because of very clever tactics of managing to discard any internal rival, let's say, such as, for example, Gideon Saar, who was second place to him in the Likud, and he managed to lower him, marginalize him. And I think that's one of the reasons now that Gideon Saar is coming back and is split from the Likud and is trying to form a coalition without Netanyahu.
Do you predict a government without Netanyahu after this coming election?
So if you read the papers, most of the commentators will say probably Netanyahu will win or we go to another round, a fifth round of election. I would like to kind of try. I think that this time, actually, the results will show that the three bigger, the major parties, which are Yesh Atid, Lapid, Saar, and Bennett, will create a sort of a triumvirate, three people leadership or three party leadership, and that will be enough to put Likud out of the coalition.
Well, Oren Taller, we've got a few days to wait and see. Oren Taller, academic, master's degree at Sydney University, Middle East expert. Thank you so much. רוצים לשמוע עוד סיפורים? האזינו דרך האפל פודקאסט, גוגל פודקאסט, ספוטיפיי, או בכל מקום אחר בו ניתן להאזין לפודקאסטים.